Hello, I'm Andrew McCormick Johnson. Since we are currently in the 150th year since the creation of Canada, Canadian history is still currently on many people's minds. Thus, I thought it would be appropriate to prepare a short presentation about the history of my hometown of Cambridge, Ontario. While admittedly nothing particularly exciting happened in Cambridge around the time of Confederation itself, Cambridge was more directly affected by an event that occurred 3 decades earlier, which proved instrumental in eventually bringing about Confederation, namely the 1837-38 Upper Canada Rebellion. For those unfamiliar with this event, I shall try to summarize it briefly. In 1837, two simultaneous rebellions broke out in the two British colonies of English-speaking Upper Canada and French-speaking Lower Canada. The Upper Canada Rebellion was led by William Lyon Mackenzie, while his French-speaking counterpart in Lower Canada was Louis-Joseph Papineau. Both rebellions were strongly rooted in the dissatisfaction of significant numbers of people with the British colonial system and an unequal social order dominated by the rich and powerful at the expense of the poor and disenfranchised. Both rebellions were driven by the desire to obtain responsible government, or government in which the people elected their own leaders directly rather than being governed exclusively by the will of the British Crown and the governor appointed on its behalf. While both rebellions failed and their leaders fled into exile, they directly inspired the Durham Report, named after British North American Governor Lord Durham, which recommended that the two colonies be unified into the single province of Canada in 1841, the introduction of responsible government that same year, and set the stage for Confederation and Canadian self-government within the British Empire 26 years later. So how did the 1837 rebellion affect Cambridge specifically? For one thing, at 84 Water Street South stands Landreth Cottage, which was completed in 1867 on what is believed to be the site of a former residence known as Liberty Cottage. In 1837, this house was occupied by Alexander Burnett, a prominent reformer who was associated with William Lyon Mackenzie's Upper Canada rebels. During the rebellion, the task of rooting out suspected rebels was given to Absalom Shade, who was appointed the local commission of the peace. Shade, a wealthy businessman and philanthropist, was a figure of great significance in the foundation of the town of Galt that Cambridge would later incorporate. He had worked with his business partner, the Right Honorable William Dixon, to purchase the land on which the settlement of Shade's Mills, which would later become Galt, in 1816, in order to establish a sawmill and a grist mill and lay the foundations of a community that would house its workers. Shade also constructed the bridge across the Grand River that stood until 1932 and was a significant financial contributor towards the construction of Trinity Anglican Church in 1844. During the rebellion, the local militia, known as the Galt Volunteers, was instructed by the magistrate in Toronto to stand on guard on the old Galt Bridge. After they received rumors that Mackenzie and other rebellion leaders might be passing through the area, though they never encountered them. It was, however, established that one of Mackenzie's associates, by the name of Samuel Lount, briefly passed through Galt on his way to Niagara, attempting to escape to the United States. He was apprehended during the attempt and later hanged in Toronto. This same militia would be tasked with confiscating the weapons of suspected rebels in the area. It also made a few arrests in the neighborhood of Mudge's Mills, in what would later become the village of Ayr. Three rebels were apprehended there, two of whom would later be reprieved, and the third of whom later died in prison. About 20 of the militiamen would later be sent to the front lines in Niagara to do battle with the rebels. Thus, the Cambridge region experienced significant activity during an event in Canada's history that would later prove highly instrumental in bringing about the advent of Confederation 3 decades later.